Thank you. Robert does, but he's not here today. Trevor. We will sing to Trevor today. So do we have the words? Probably no, but yes, let's sing to Trevor.
Patriarchs.
Patriarchs. And this week is prophets. Well done, Jane. Brilliant. So we have patriarchs and prophets, and we're going to light both of these now. I'm going to look in that direction. That's absolutely fine. So if we can have an older person from among us who might like to come, please, and light our candles.
And show all the world God's love.
So we remember the prophets. We remember the prophets today. Those who have announced God's story in history, and sometimes in the scriptures we see that is in difficult times and sometimes to difficult people, and they're not always responded to very well. So we might think of those in our own history, in our own lives, who have announced God's story to us. And we might also think of our own hearts and how we need within our own souls to keep announcing God's story, to keep that alive within our own lives. And sometimes we wrestle against our own souls and our own hearts announcing that story within us, depending on what our lives are doing at this time. And so thinking of all of that, we bring ourselves to God. We come to God as one from whom no secrets are hidden, to ask for his forgiveness and peace. For turning away from you and ignoring your will for our lives, Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For behaving just as we wish without thinking of you, Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For failing you by what we do and think and say, Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For letting ourselves be drawn away from you by temptations in the world about us, Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
For living as if we were ashamed to belong to your Son, Father, forgive us.
Save us and help us.
So So may the God of all healing and forgiveness draw us to himself and cleanse us from all our sins, that we may behold the glory of his Son, the Word made flesh, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Moment we stand because and only because Jesus. is also a sense that there is a process happening within us before that final refining. St. Paul speaks of salvation as an ongoing process which we are in and part of in the here and now, not just some distant day in the future. But as well as our salvation being finished in what Jesus has done for us, it is also being worked out in us. It has that dual meaning. For the grammar nerds, it's continuous present. So it's happened and it is happening. And I wonder what that feels like to you. What does it mean and what does it feel like for salvation to be working itself out within you? In the time of Advent, these are big themes that we are asked to think about. The themes of judgment and salvation. They're not always comfortable, but Advent is the time to do it. When silver as a metal is being worked out, it's quite a rigorous process. And I wonder if your salvation, your walking with the Lord and becoming more like Jesus every day, feels a bit rigorous at the moment. Does it feel like hard work or hard things are being done inside you that you're learning? Maybe you feel a bit battered by it and you'd rather actually not have this process going on. Having to follow the way of the cross is not easy and it can be costly. If that is the case, I'm afraid I'm not going to make it any easier for you. But I do want you to know that you're not alone. Not now, because the people beside you, I'm sure, feel the same. But also not in the whole history of those who have followed Jesus. You know, Mother Julian, St. Ignatius, Teresa of Avila, the mystics of our tradition. You are in good company with them in feeling that working out happening in the tough moments of life, perhaps especially in those moments. And I would be very surprised if all of us here have not had those moments, even if you're not experiencing them now, of that salvation process feeling very hard indeed. Malachi, the messenger, tells us that we have put ourselves in the hands of the Lord. When we say yes to God, when we agree, or when we agreed, whenever that moment was for you, maybe it's a moment, maybe it's a process, but whenever you feel you have said yes to God, you put yourselves in God's hands. You said yes to that process. And it might be hard, but you're in God's hands, and where else would you rather be? Malachi also talks of the offerings of that refining being pleasing, acceptable to the Lord. In other places in Scripture, these offerings, sometimes sort of noted as being in the form of prayers, sometimes in the form of sacrifices. So in the form of prayers, sometimes this idea of a pleasing odor being lifted to God. As it says in other places, the prayers of the saints are like sweet-smelling incense. Or St. Paul, who invites us in the book of Romans to offer ourselves as living sacrifices, that our whole lives are offered to God in the same way that meat or grain was burnt in an offering to God to release that smell. You can almost smell it, that yummy Sunday roast that you might go home to. That smell pleasing to God. And we are asked to be living versions of those things, our lives to be sweet smelling offerings to the Lord. It's a bit of a challenge, isn't it, sometimes? Why in some churches they burn incense at each service. It's a sign and a symbol of that pleasing offering, even as our salvation is being worked out, even if it's hard work, and even if we don't feel that we have been partnering with the Holy Spirit in that working out. It feels a bit more like a wrestling match, even in those moments, just having that sign and symbol to remind us that we are to be sweet-smelling offerings to the Lord. So I'm going to give these things out to you now, which are little packets of incense. Little packets of incense. So in each of these are a few grains of incense for you to take. You do have to be careful with incense, it burns very hot. So if you so you might like to burn it in a candle burner. It will be quite smoky, so be careful. Burn it outside, or you may like to keep this little packet of incense in your wallet or in your purse and just have it as a little shiny reminder that this is what you are called to be, to be these sweet smelling offerings, a pleasing offering to the Lord. Loving God, as we allow the working out of your salvation in us, help us to say yes to you, even when it's hard. And may our offering of ourselves be as sweet-smelling incense. Amen. Please would you stand as we sing. Thank you. I'm going to use the text from the reading that we had in our prayers. And at the end, I'm going to invite you to come up and give a symbol of your offering of yourself to the Lord by lighting a small candle, bringing it to the manger as a way of symbolizing what we bring, small as it might be, to the Lord. See, I am sending my messenger to prepare the way before me. Loving God, help us to be your messengers, messengers of good news and God's favor. Show us where we need to go and to whom we should speak. May our lives in our thoughts, words, and deeds be a pleasing offering. And we ask for your help for those who show your practical love, who are messengers of your good news in those kinds of ways. Particularly we think of the food bank, we think of Firm Foundation, we think of the Winter Night Shelter, and the street pastors who encounter people in need whenever they go out. We thank you for them being symbols and signs of your good news, being messengers in that way. And we pray for each of us as we speak of your love in our lives, in the places where you have set us, the communities to which you have called us. Show us what actions will speak of your love. And give us words where they are needed. But can endure the day of his coming. Loving God, we are enduring the current days in the hope of your justice and mercy reigning when you come. Help us to be your people in faithfulness as we endure, and make us ready to welcome you so that we may endure in the day of your coming. So as we offer ourselves to your salvation process, Lord, help us to take courage, help us to be obedient. And when the process feels very hard, may we know and take comfort that we are in your hands and there is nowhere else we would rather be. Until they present offerings to the Lord in righteousness. Loving God, receive our offerings of ourselves today. And as we come and bring these candles, I ask that your Holy Spirit works in us to draw us closer to you and to open our hearts further to you, to your Spirit, and to the callings which you have put on all our lives. And may they be as sweet-smelling incense. And so I invite you to come and to light your candle from our Advent, one of our Advent candles, just to place it on the table here in front of our manger to show your commitment to offering your life to Jesus. And remembering that the tender darkness allows the light to shine. The darkness does not overcome the light, but gives it space. So even in those places which are more difficult for us, there can be tenderness in those spaces. So please come and light your candle.
Your will be done on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
In the tender mercy of our God, the day spring from on high shall break upon us to give light to those who dwell in darkness and in the shadow of death, and to guide our feet into the way of peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
So as we go, I send you off with a blessing. Momentarily, just before that, just to say, if you are physically able to, we're going to be setting up for the nativity service after we've had some coffee and chat. But if you're able to stay and you're able to help us with that, that would be very much appreciated. So Christ, the Son of Righteousness, shine upon you. Scatter the darkness from before your path, and make you ready to meet him when he comes in glory. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father,